NerdDice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 60 in our series, Create a RubyGem NerdDice. And we are nearing completion for our 0.3 release. So you can see our milestones. Everything else we've got as an issue is a later milestone. We've got our items added to the benchmark and everything. We just need to make sure before we merge this that we've got up-to-date comments and change log and all that stuff. So let's open a pull request like we did last time. With our feature ability scores branch here. I'll write my description. All right, simple enough, pull request description. Our commits differences are all coming in here. Files changed is where we'll look at our documentation here, so, and our change log. So these are relevant. I don't think I modified the, let's take a look at our change log and README. We'll get them open. So our change log. We're still unreleased on this, so add NerdDice benchmark script is at the level of added here. Let's take a look at the rest of these. NerdDice. So that'll be a change that we want to note in the change log. And write this bullet. So we've got that in as a change. Continue down our list. Class methods, configuration, we are execute die roll, so these are not really changed, just moved. So harvest totals is brand new, so we'd want to add that in our changelog and our README. So I've got harvest totals noted here in the changelog as being added. Take a look at the file here. We can add this now to the README using a very similar format to this. README. We'll add a section called section here, we'll call it utility methods. All description here. So we've got our section here. Oh, let me get rid of the... Well, actually, let me add that into the Ruby block here. We've got that. Let's continue down our diff here. Fresh seed didn't really get changed. Role ability scores is new. It is properly commented, so I think we're good there. Alright, so I've added in my role ability scores and total ability scores methods to the changelog. Let's now take a look at the README. So we've got usage information, argument information here. And it's going to be very similar for this. We can put them in the same block of the README. Put it right here. The idea, I'll write it. So I've got this section adapted over to the README. We'll continue down our, let me save it, continue down our list of diffs here. Roll ability scores, roll dice doesn't change. Total ability scores we accounted for in both the changelog and the other item, total dice hasn't changed. Configuration has changed. So we need to add that to our changelog and our README. Let's start with the changelog. So the thing we've changed in configuration is that we've, I'll just write it and then we'll talk about it. So our change is that we're now enforcing that NerdDice configuration ability score array size must be a positive duck type integer. Before we had just it as a, as an attribute accessor with no validations associated with it. And we'll add in the other ones just as a bulleted list about the in the added section. So I've got the new attributes accounted for. Let's take a closer look at our differences here. All right, now let's take a look at the README and make our needed changes there. So let's make our changes here. All right, so I've added in the new configuration information. I've also added in a note about that behavior with ability score dice kept and ability score dice rolled, so that it describes the behavior there, because it's not necessarily self-evident what's going to happen there. So we've got that. The next class we've got is, that is not modified really. These are our specs. Continue on, shared examples. I'm not even sure whether that's mentioning in the chain. Definitely not in the README, but I think I will mention it in the change log. Yeah, even at the change log level, I don't think mentioning the spec support stuff is relevant. We didn't do it before. We'll leave that alone. Let's take a look now at our README. One thing I want to do is I'm going to add a section to the README here about the Codecast videos that have been made in order to as this thing has been developed. So that's something I'll put right at the top with a link to the YouTube version of this playlist, at least for now. And then we'll go from there. All right, so I've got that noted there. There was also some awkward language as it relates to the development copyright section. Let me fix that. So I just added the word additional here so that that sentence is little bit clearer. Let's see here. There is one more change I'd like to make. So the, if we look at our class methods here, we have a file called configuration, and then we've got the configuration class there. So I would like to change that, since if we go into this, it's got the configure method as well. So we're just going to rename this configure and make sure that our specs still pass and everything. So let's take a look at that. We will So the other thing I changed here was I just added a new comment line, because I had left out the randomization technique at the top of the class comment there. So, or the source code file comment. So, lib nerddice class methods. We need to change it in class methods here. See how much I broke. working. RuboCop's still happy. Let's take a look at our spec items there. So we just have configuration spec there, and then in the NerdDice spec itself we have the configuration stuff, so that doesn't have a file that needs to be renamed at this point. So we can do a final review here. Oh, I do need, let me check the output of these markdown files before we commit them. So we'll start with the README. Just look at the preview here. Sure, the link works. It does. Installation, usage, configuration. Want lower and modified to be italicized rather than bolded there. So trying to make that bold italic and just normal italic for that. We'll see how that turns out. Preview, that is what I want there. Keep going down, taking actions, available options. That is not what I want there. Let's fix that. That looks like it was just ordered incorrectly. Let's try that again. Look at the preview. Been fixed. Our new section on rolling ability scores. Those look good. That does not look good. Horrendous. Let's fix that. So that was just code that I intended to remove and forgot to. Let's look again. This is why you do this sort of thing before committing and releasing your code with horrendous errors in your Markdown. That all looks good. Harvest total section looks good. All right, I think the README is in good shape. Let's take a look at the changelog. Changelog looks all good. So I think we're ready to commit this. When we do this, I'll note that it closes number 7. Pause and write the message. So I've got the commit message. I'll sign it. Now I can push. We'll ensure that the action still passes here. Specs pass. Now we can merge to master remotely. Seems to have worked. We will push to master. Our pull request should show as closed. Our referenced issue closes that issue. Our issue section here, down to 2 open issues. We look at our 0.3 milestone. Everything is there. Let's make sure that master succeeded. It did. Our README has some horizontal scrolling, but that we'll take it. And I think we're ready for 0.3 release. So in our next video, we'll move our changelog down. We'll build our gem and we'll release it, tag the git commit with the release, and do all that stuff. Exciting times. Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.